Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome to another video of Meal Prep Sunday. I am super excited again this week. This week on the meal plan is sausage pancake bake. Some of you may remember a couple weeks ago I did a pancake bake using blueberries. This week I'm not going to use fruit, I'm going to use sausage, so super excited to try that. And then for lunches this week, we are going to be doing blue cheese buffalo turkey meatballs. And we're gonna pair that with some broccoli Normandy, so that should be good. And then I'm going to be pre-packaging four dinners this week. I think for the night that we have tacos, I'm not really gonna be pre-packaging that, but I probably am gonna go ahead and cook the taco meat so that that's ready to go. So if you wanna see how I prep breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks for my husband and I, then stay with me. And if you're new to my channel and you like videos like this, please go ahead and click that subscribe button and click the notification bell so you're notified anytime I upload new content. And welcome, my name is Christy and I am planning us healthy. Do is make the sausage pancake bake. So for this recipe, we are going to need 2 cups of Kodiak cakes, the flapjack and waffle mix. So 2 cups of that. We're going to need 1.5 cups of almond milk. You can use regular milk if you want, but it is going to change the points. These, I'm going to make 12, I'm going to cut this into 12, and it's going to be 5 points each. So any changes that you make, you'll have to make sure you adjust the points for it. And then we're going to need 1 teaspoon of vanilla, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. I'm going to use a whole bag of the Jimmy Dean turkey sausage crumbles. And then 1 egg. And also 2 very ripe bananas. As you can see, that's very ripe. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and mix everything together. And if you don't like to use banana in it, you could use applesauce, or you could even probably just use a little bit more milk. I know the last time I made those, people were asking me if you had to use banana in it. So just go ahead and mash up the banana real good. And pour that in there. And then our egg, and then 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And then go ahead and stir that up. Now we're going to fold in the sausage. And this sausage is already fully cooked. So if you get sausage that's not cooked, I would say go ahead and definitely cook it first. If you wanted to lower the points down, these are, like I said, these are going to be 5 points. You could definitely just do some of the turkey. I would say probably half the bag would do it. I'm not sure, I didn't plug it in there. But I know without the turkey crumbles, it's 3 points for each serving. So adding the turkey crumbles is adding another 2 points per serving. So I'm going to add the whole bag, and then I'll see if it's too much of a turkey flavor, then I know next time to use less. All right, the next thing we're gonna do is spray our pan with olive oil spray. All right, and then we're just gonna go ahead and put that in the pan. I can't wait to try this. Okay, then we're going to put that in a preheated 350 degree oven for about 30 minutes. When I did the pancake bake the first time, I tried it at 20 minutes and it wasn't quite done, so my oven did take 30 minutes. So because all ovens vary, I would definitely recommend checking it after 20 minutes and basically just check it like you would a cake, stick a toothpick in it and see if it's done all the way. But mine did take 30 minutes last time. Okay, so while that is in the oven, I'm gonna go ahead and put some syrup into these little containers. And I did find a bunch of little containers, and a lot of people have been asking me where I get my containers. These I found at Dollar Tree, and let me show you. There is little square ones, and then there's round ones. And they fit, I think it was like between 2 and 3 ounces. .29 cups and 2.3 ounces for the round ones. And the same for the square ones. So Dollar Tree, $1 for 10 of them. So they're gonna be perfect. I mean, they're cheap. They're just cheap little plastic ones, but they'll be perfect for what I need it for. So I'm doing 1/8 of a cup. I don't want to have a point, so 1/8 of a cup is 0 points. So I'm going to just go ahead and measure out or weigh out 30 milliliters into each container. I don't know if those are gonna work. Those lids are really loose. So I'm gonna probably have to put some tape over those. Yeah, they don't snap. Okay, definitely gonna need to tape those. So we'll still be on the hunt for more containers. Definitely need some snap lids for syrup because we will have a mess with that. It'd probably be all right as long as I put it in the container that I have the pancake bake in. So, okay, so that's done. We're gonna go ahead and move on to the lunch. Okay, so for the lunch, again, we are making blue cheese buffalo turkey meatballs. They're from Home Chef. I did make some modifications in, I'm using light butter and I'm using ground turkey breast. So this is ground turkey breast that I get from Walmart. It's farm to family. So I am using 36 ounces. It calls for 12 ounces for two. So I'm gonna be making 6, so I need 36 ounces of turkey breast. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is take about 6 green onions. Cut the ends off. And then I want the white parts for in the turkey, and then the rest I am going to cut up for just to have to garnish it afterwards. All right, so we're gonna just put that right in there and then we'll cut the rest of it up. Actually, that piece is pretty much. We'll cut the rest of it up for garnish. Okay, so we're just gonna set that aside. Now we're gonna add just some salt and pepper. And finally, 3 ounces of, I'm using the Frigo crumbled blue cheese. We want 3 ounces of that. And then just go ahead and mix it all up. And you really have to kind of squeeze the cheese, otherwise it stays in clumps. All right, the next thing I'm gonna do is weigh the whole thing. Okay, so this recipe actually, for one serving, it is 4 meatballs, but I found last time that the meatballs were a little bit big, so when I made them last time, I cut them in half. So what I'm gonna do is each serving is gonna be 8 small meatballs, so I just weighed it out, and so each meatball that I make is going to end up being about 23 grams. So let me show you how big that's going to be. So each meatball is going to be this size. So if you prefer, you can make them bigger. I like them better smaller. They seem to cook better and looks like you're eating more. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get these meatballs all rolled out. And the other things that you're gonna need for this is, I use light butter, and I use about 1¾ ounces of light butter. And also, where's my hot sauce? I use Frank's Red Hot Sauce. And we use 3 ounces of that. That though is to your liking. You don't have to use the full 3 ounces if you don't like it hot. You could definitely use less. All we're gonna do is we're gonna cook the turkey meatballs and then mix the butter and hot sauce in with it. So you can kind of do it to your liking. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these rolled out and then I'll come back to you. Okay, so the pancake bake is done and it looks delicious. It smells delicious. I actually forgot, I usually add cinnamon over the top of it before I bake it, and I forgot. So I did just sprinkle a little bit of cinnamon on it when it came out. So I'm gonna set this aside and let it cool while we do the meatballs. Okay, so I have my pan sprayed. I actually went ahead and cooked my chicken breast for the night we have tacos. So this is just chicken breast with the taco seasoning, and I'm just simmering that. So I have the meatballs on medium. I have the pan on medium and I have it sprayed with olive oil spray. My olive oil spray kind of went in spurts rather than spray. So I'm going to just go ahead and add the meatballs. So I have the meatballs portioned out into 23 gram pieces. I can get them off the plate. And it makes 48 of them. So I'll have 8 per serving. And hopefully I can fit them all in here. This is going to be a tight squeeze. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do these in batches, because there's just way too many in there and I can't really turn them. So I'll do them in batches. Okay. There we go. It's a little easier. Now we have room to turn them. Okay, so we'll let these cook and I will come back. All right, so I have the second batch in. I have the first batch done. They actually did take a full 12 minutes. So I'm gonna get these cooking and get these done, and then I'll show you what we do next. All right, so I went ahead and added the other meatballs back. So now we're gonna take them off the burner. Slide you over here. And now we're just going to add the butter. And however much hot sauce you want, which, like I said, we use all of it. A bit more in there. Okay, and then just kind of swirl it around, get it all coated, and then we'll just let that sit and let them cool down. But just make sure you get it all coated real good. Okay, we'll let that cool down and I will move on to dinners for now. Okay guys, so while the meatballs are cooling, I'm gonna go ahead and start on dinners. So if you're new to my channel, when I prep my dinners, I'm not cooking them. I am not washing the vegetables. I am simply just portioning everything out, putting them in marked bags, and putting them in the fridge for the night we have them. So basically, I'm just labeling the bags with whatever it is that we're having. I'm putting how many points there are per serving. And then I'm just putting, if there's vegetables, I put vegetables in the bag. I portion out my meats and just have everything all ready just for the two portions that we're having for that night. Sometimes I do make more than two portions. And in fact, for the pork chops, I usually do make more for the breading. And then that way I just take out what I need for that night and then I have breading for a different night. So depending on what the recipe is, I sometimes do prep it more. For example, for the tacos, I went ahead, as you saw, I cooked my taco meat. I put it in a container and I'm just gonna go ahead and put that in the bag. So the taco meat is already cooked. So all I have to do that night is heat it up. And then, but normally I don't cook everything. I just put the meat and everything in the bag. So for taco night, I am gonna go ahead and put this in here. I have my lettuce that I have already cut up. And then I'm gonna put my tomato in there. I have some sour cream that I put in a little container. And then we are gonna use Velveeta shreds. I'm not measuring these out or weighing these out because cheese, when we have tacos, the amount of cheese I use depends on how I'm doing that day. So I'm going to wait until dinner that night and that will determine how much cheese I will allow myself to have on my taco. And then we put, of course, we put taco sauce and sometimes we put green onion. So, but this is all I'm going to go ahead and prep in the bag for now. And then everything else I'll just go ahead and get out. I don't normally prep the tacos, but for tonight I went ahead and did it. Okay. So now I'll show you pretty much what I normally do with dinner. So the first one I'm going to be doing is air fryer basil parmesan salmon with rice. I'm going to be making, I switched this one. I had originally planned on my meal plan. I had put that I was going to have broccoli this night, but because we're having the broccoli Normandy for lunches, I decided to do ranch cauliflower this night. So what I'm going to do, and this is going to be 7 points per serving. This recipe actually is a skinny taste recipe, and I actually had not seen this one. Jen, one of my faithful subscribers, told me about this one, and then Joan from Joan's Pointed Plate said she made this a couple weeks ago and that it was really good. So I am really anxious to try this. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm making ranch cauliflower with it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and break up the cauliflower and put it in the bag. All right, so now I'm just gonna kind of break it apart into a little bit more bite-sized pieces. And I'm just gonna put that in the bottom of the bag. And then the night that I come home from work, that we're gonna make this, actually this will be tomorrow night. So tomorrow night when I get home from work, I will take all the vegetables out and wash them then. All right, so that's all broke in two pieces. All right, so for the ranch cauliflower, all I do is I roast the cauliflower in the oven and then I just top it with some a mixture of light sour cream and ranch dressing mix. So I'm going to put 2 ounces of sour cream in this dish. And then 1 teaspoon of the ranch dressing mix. And then my husband and I will split this. I'll have half and he'll have half. And we'll just drizzle it over the cauliflower. So this way, this is already combined. It's ready to go that night. And it just makes it so much quicker when I get home from work to just grab the bag out of the fridge and everything's portioned and everything's ready to go and I can quickly cook dinner. I usually, during the week, can have dinner on the table between 15 minutes and 30 minutes, depending on what it is and how long it takes to cook. So it is definitely a help. So even though it does take me a little bit of time today, it's taking away from during the week when I have to work. All right, so that is that. The other thing I'm gonna have with the salmon is the 92nd long grain and wild rice. This rice is 5 points for a cup. I usually just have a half a cup for 3 points. So I'm just putting that in the bag. And I'm just putting this in the bag. If this isn't going in the fridge. Again, I'm just putting this in here so that you guys can see what I'm having with it. So then when I put my bags up, you just see what I'm having with it. And so what I'll do is I'll just put that back in my pantry before I put everything else in the fridge. And then I'm going to put my salmon in there. Normally we have a 5 ounce piece of, whether we have chicken or if we have steak or something, we try to keep our portions down to 5 ounces, except for when it comes to salmon. Whenever we have salmon, we usually split a pound. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. This portion is amount for 4 people for the salmon because I am using a pound of salmon and then I'm using enough for 4 servings of the topping. So this is actually three smart points per serving. So we may go ahead and have, because we usually split the pound, we're going to end up with 2 servings. So ours will be 6 points. For the salmon. So probably what I'll do is I might not have the rice. If I have the 2 portions of salmon, then I won't have the rice. So just keep in mind that this amount is for 4 servings. So I'm gonna put the sour cream, and then I have another one that I'm gonna mark. I'm marking this that it's the topping because they both look similar. Okay, and then for the topping, this is a mixture of 3 tablespoons of light mayonnaise and then 3 tablespoons of Parmesan cheese, and I just mixed it together. And then it also calls for about 6 fresh leaves of basil, and I'm gonna mince these and mix it in with this. But I don't want to do that tonight. I don't want to prep that yet because I'm afraid that if I put that in there and let it sit for a day, it's gonna be way too strong of basil taste. So I'm gonna wait. And I'm just gonna put this in the bag like this, and I'm gonna mince it tomorrow night when I get home, and then I'll mix it with this and then put the topping on the fish. Okay, and the other thing we need is half a lemon. I actually have a lemon tree that gives off little tiny lemons, so I'm just gonna use a whole one since it's so small. I'm gonna throw that in there. All right, and that's all we do, that's it. And then like I said, I'll take the rice out and put it in my pantry. But just for the picture purpose, I'll leave it in there. Okay, for the next one. The next one is air fryer crispy breaded pork chops with potato mash and cheesy Brussels sprouts. I actually do have a cook along, or a cook with me out there. I'll put a card up above for that. So for this one, tonight we have this, we're gonna have Brussels sprouts. So again, these are frozen Brussels sprouts, but I'm just putting them in the bag just to show for the picture at the end, basically. That's the only reason I do that. I will be taking this out of the bag, and I'll be taking the rice out of the bag. Everything else will go in the fridge. And then I have 2 5-ounce portions of boneless pork chops. And put those in there. And then I'm going to make potato mash. I'm just going to use 3/4 of a pound of potatoes, which is about what this is actually 12.2 pounds. So I'm just going to use that. And when I do my potato mash for this night, I'm not going to use milk. I'm just going to use, sometimes I'll like, when I make it, I just add back in some of the water from the potato from when I boiled it. Okay, and then the topping for this one, I have two portions of the pork chops. This topping, though, is going to make enough for six. So what I usually do is, it's the recipe I get it off of is skinnytaste.com, and rather than try and yield it down to just two, I just leave it six, and then I just take out one third of it, and then I mark on the bag what it is, and I keep it in my pantry, so then the next time I make it, I won't have to put this together. So for the six portions, this is half a cup of panko, 1/3 cups of crushed cornflakes, and then 2 tablespoons of Parmesan cheese. And then we're also going to add to it 1/2 teaspoon of onion powder. Whoops. A 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder. And then a good heaping teaspoon of paprika. And then I'm going to add some pepper. And you can also add salt. I'm not going to add salt to this. And then just mix it up. And then we've got our breading for the pork chops. And this will last me for 3 separate dinners. So this will be enough to cover 6 pork chops. And I'm just labeling that it's pork chop breading so that when I put it back in my pantry. And then what I'll do is tomorrow night after I take out the portion, I'll just put how much is left in it. If it's for I'll just write for 4 pork chops, and then the next time I use it, I'll cross it off and put for 2. And then the other thing that we're going to need with this one is an egg, which I'm not going to put the egg in the bag. So there are some things that I don't put in the bag. So that is that one, and now we just have one more. Okay, so for the next night, this one I'm hoping to do a cook with me for. This one I'm super excited about. I just had a thought the other day of Hasselback chicken, and I was trying to think of different things that I could do with it. And I thought about a Philly-style Hasselback chicken. There may already be something out there for it. I did not Google it because I wanted to do my own thing and see how it comes out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to saute some onions and peppers, and I'm going to cut the slits in the chicken breast, and then I'm going to put the onions and peppers in the slits, and then I'm going to top it with provolone cheese. So I think it's going to turn out super good. This one, I think in my meal plan, this was the one I was going to have the ranch cauliflower with, but since I switched it and I'm doing the ranch cauliflower with the salmon, I decided to do zucchini and squash lime crema. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but that was a recipe. I think it was like back when I did the Home Chef deliveries. I think it was something I got off of that. So it is super good. You just roast zucchini and squash and you mix it with sour cream and lime. So I did forget to buy lime, so I have some lime juice left that I'm going to put in there. So we want 2 ounces of sour cream. And then our lime. I'm not going to mix those together because, again, I don't want the lime to overpower it. So what we're going to put in the bag is a zucchini and a squash. And on Wednesday nights, I don't usually do potato or rice or anything. So that's all I'm going to be having with it is the zucchini and squash and then the chicken. So I'm going to put in, I have a part of a green pepper here. I think I'm going to go ahead and add a yellow pepper. I'm not going to end up using all of it. And then an onion. And then I have 2 chicken breasts that I had already prepackaged. These are about 6 ounces each. So I'll put that in there. So as you can see, some of this is really easy to prepare. I mean, I could go through and cut up the vegetables for this if I wanted to make it even quicker, but it's just as quick that night to cut those up. And then, I don't know for sure, I'm probably going to add some seasonings on the chicken. Again, I've never made this, so I'm really hoping to do a cook with me that night. So I'm just going to go ahead, as I always do, I always put the recipe links down in the description box, either the actual recipe that I came up with or the links. So I'm going to go ahead and put just the generic basic recipe down in the description box for now. But after I make it Wednesday night, I will go back through and I will change it and add, any spices that I added. When I make things like this, I have it in mind and then I won't know until that night that I actually make it in order to put the recipe there. So that's why sometimes people will ask me when I do my meal plan, they'll ask me for some of the recipes, and that's why I've never linked those down there because I don't necessarily know either until today or until the day that I make it. So for this one, maybe wait until when that cook with me comes out on Wednesday. And I almost forgot about the sour cream and the lime. Put that in there. Okay, so there is that one. So we are done with dinners. Now we'll move on to, we have to finish up our breakfast and lunch. Okay, so this made really big portions. That is cut into six. So that's a pretty big portion. So I'm just gonna cut that in half so that it will fit better in my containers. I actually don't have enough containers of the same, so I'm just putting them in there like that, and then I will put the syrup in there. I went ahead and just taped the lids on there so that they're not gonna spill all over. So that is it for breakfast. Can't wait to try those. Okay, so for the lunches, to go with the meatballs, I have this huge bag of broccoli Normandy that I picked up at Sam's Club. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and put some of that in the containers, just frozen, and then they will unthaw during the week and then just heat them up when we reheat the meatballs. All right, you guys, so I was sitting here spooning out the meatballs, talking away to you guys, and I looked up and my phone was off. I had run out of memory, so had to unload all the videos and come back to you. So I think where we left off, I had already done the broccoli Normandy, and all I did was spoon out the meatballs. So I have 8 meatballs in each section, and so this whole thing is going to be 3 points each, so not too bad. Like I said, these meatballs are really good. And again, you don't have to add the hot sauce. If you don't like spice, you can definitely do them without hot sauce. If you don't like turkey meatballs, you could definitely do it with something else. Just make sure to adjust for the points. So now I'm just going to go ahead and put my green onions over top of them. All right, that is that. So I'm going to put these away and I'll come back and show you my snacks. Alright, so for those of you wondering about the other 2 days, what we do for breakfast and lunch on the other 2 days, one day on Friday we are going to go out for lunch. We're probably going to have a Subway sub. On Thursday, usually what I do is I usually make a chicken salad or tuna sandwich, or I think this week what I'm going to do is a Laughing Cow turkey wrap, which is basically just a 1-point Olay Extreme Wellness wrap. I put one wedge of Laughing Cow cheese on it and then 2 ounces of turkey, put some vegetables on it, and I have that for lunch. For the other two mornings, I have my cereal and my milk. And I actually forgot to get bananas this week, so I won't be having a banana with it. But this is 30 grams of Fiber One Original Cereal. And this is a 1/2 cup of vanilla unsweetened almond milk. So this is 0. Anything over 1/2 cup becomes 1. And this is 2 points. So that is my breakfast for Thursday and Friday. Last week, I actually didn't eat both of them. So I still have one at work from last week. So I only needed to do one for this week. And then for our snacks, we have yogurt and pudding. And then I have, I measured out my pretzels already. You guys don't need to see me measuring that out. So I have 28 grams of the Snack Factory pretzels, pretzel crisps. And then I have one wedge of Laughing Cow cheese. This is a 4-point snack. And then I usually do about 4 of those, make about 4 of those. And then we are going to have, for fruit this week, we're having grapes and cantaloupe, so I've already cut those up and did that off camera. So that is it, I think, for prep. So now I'm going to put everything out and show you what we ended up with. Okay, guys, here it is. So here is our prep. So starting with the snacks, I have my 3-point pretzels with my 1-point Laughing Cow cheese for a 4-point snack. We have our 2-point puddings, our 2-point yogurts, 0-point fruit bowls. I have my Fiber One cereal, 2 points for that, 1/2 cup for my unsweetened vanilla almond milk. And then we have our breakfast bake, the sausage breakfast bake. I will say that one thing I'm a little bit concerned about is when I did the breakfast bake the last time, I used blueberries. So the blueberries kind of gave it some sweetness, so I am a little bit worried about that just those bananas are not going to give it enough sweetness. So I'm hoping with the syrup that will be enough. If not, then next time I may just add a little bit of sweetener to it. So I will let you guys know after I try this tomorrow morning. By the time this video goes up, I will put in the description box whether it was sweet enough for my liking. I'm fine with stuff that's not really sweet. So again, you just kind of have to see if it's sweet enough for you. So, and then we have our 3-point lunch. I can't remember if I said these are 5 points. So 5 points for the breakfast bake and 0 for the 1/8 cup of sugar-free syrup. And then our 3-point lunch, super excited about this. So 3-point lunch for our buffalo turkey meatballs. Blue cheese buffalo turkey meatballs. And then for dinners this week, we have tacos. Not sure how many points that's going to be. I put 12 because I won't know until the night I have it. Depends how much sour cream and how much cheese I put on it. And then the air fryer basil parmesan salmon. Cannot wait to try that. That is 7 points per serving. I did use light mayonnaise, so I will put, if it changes besides 7, you'll have the updated version down in the description box by the time I put it up. Because I used light mayonnaise, I don't know if that's going to make a difference. So all the points will be correct in the description box by the time I have this video up. And then air fryer crispy breaded pork chops. I'm going to do that with potato mash and cheesy Brussels sprouts. I put 10 Freestyle Smart points for that because with the potatoes and everything, that's what it's going to come to. I think for the pork chops alone, I believe it's 5. Like I said, I do have a cook with me out there, and that has the points on it as well. And then Wednesday night, super excited. I'm hoping to do a cook with me on this one. The Philly style Hasselback chicken with zucchini and squash, lime crema. 4 Freestyle Smart points per serving. That is for everything. For the vegetables and the chicken. So super excited to try that. So let you know how it turns out. Okay guys, so that's it. Another week is done. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks for the two of us. I'm super excited to try this week. I will let you know. Like I said, everything will be down in the description box. the points that are on these are not necessarily accurate. It just depends how it ends up being once I plug them all into the Weight Watchers app. So I will definitely have the corrected points down below in the description box. So I appreciate you guys so much. Please, if you like this video, as always, give it a thumbs up. And these are, the meal preps are my most popular, so please feel free to share this with any of your friends or any of your groups that you have. And again, if you're new, please consider subscribing to my channel. And that's it for me for this week. So I hope you guys have an amazing week, and I'll see you in my next video. I'm Christy, and I am planning us healthy.